Hey folks, welcome back to Grand Theft Auto 3 on the series JG. Having some challenges with this package pickup mission for Donald Love, but I think I got it this time. All you've missed is me driving back to the start point for the mission, and we'll even listen to the mission brief one more time. Hopefully just one more time. No thank you for the Oriental gentleman either. I saved his life. Shot him a few times, but saved his life.
In these days of moral hypocrisy, certain valuable commodities can be hard to import.
He's talking about human flesh. I'm pretty sure he's talking about human flesh.
We'll pass over the bay. It will drop several packages into the water. Make sure you pick them up before anyone else does.
I mean, they could be drugs, they could be weapons, but I don't think so. Liberty City Stories in particular makes it clear that this guy's a cannibal. It's implied in this game a few times, but okay, great start so far. Good grief. I even positioned the car to be facing the right direction and everything. And I remember what turn I need to make here. It should be real simple. So the time I got screwed up in Chinatown, I actually went the right way. I just need to be more careful with my turns. And there's that parking lot, like, with elevated bumps and stuff for the... It's the convention center where we had that policeman ball mission where we had to bring all the hookers. Like, that, I got caught up in there. I just need to give that place a wider berth and not get into trouble with that guy. Oh, fuck. Just gave him a quick love tap from the Uzi just to remind him that he's scum. So, turned too early. Now I turned right. Rather at the right time. I was actually turning left. But this is where we need to go. This is the only way to get to that boat. Flipping my car was not a good idea, but fuck. Everything was going too well, I suppose. Still the best time we've made so far, even with me flipping the car at the last minute. And I always am nervous with the cameras in this game are so fucking terrible. Always get nervous maneuvering around on foot at the docks. Okay, so we need to get out here and here's the dodo. We just want to be underneath it as it flies. Kind of be seeing where it's going. Okay. Can't see it anymore. It's making me nervous. Here it is. And you get more and more wanted stars as you pick up these packages, of course. Now this is annoying. How am I... Even when I'm perfectly positioned, they're going to be trying to get the packages before I can. I figured they would be chasing me after I had the packages and if I was positioned right. A heavy-duty wanted level I'm gonna have here. Okay, now I gotta take him back to Donald Love. First thing I gotta do is not get caught on this dock. Because I don't know exactly where I'm supposed to go. Is it to this dock? It does not appear to be on this dock. This might be, I guess, where we go to the last island. It's so freaking dark, I can't tell what's going on directly in front of me. But I guess we're going... I mean, if I'm in a speedboat and the cops can't catch me, that's fine. We're back on the Staunton Island map. I guess we were considered to be in the other map before. I hope it's not telling me to take it to Donald Love's base, and I was supposed to get out of the boat and get in a car, because at this point, I'm assuming I'm taking it someplace in the boat, and that is exactly what it was telling me. I'm supposed to be getting it to Donald Love's... Oh, fuck. Okay. I just hit something which I couldn't identify. At a 5-star wanted level, which is presenting its own challenges once we get back on land. So what I probably need to do is either plan this out to go to a town, a part of town I know where I can get to a safe house, or just, I can try to just get off of this boat here. This is going to be tricky, though. Because even just regular old, you can freaking die trying to get out. Okay. And now I'm getting shot by a helicopter. Yeah, look at this. I've taken like more than 25 damage to the armor, and I haven't even encountered anybody that I could possibly do anything about. I was worried a police car was chasing me there. I wasn't even sure. Oh, come on. That's bullshit. I thought I was going to steal an FBI car. That would have been awesome. Instead, they instantly arrest me. I hate that. I thought I was going to pull out in an FBI car. I thought I had that. Okay, so there's more to this mission than I thought. This is going to be tricky. I should consider just getting back to the first island and hitting my police wanted stars and losing the wanted level. This is the best opportunity you have to steal FBI cards, which don't appear in game unless you've got 5 stars, wanted level or more, but it's really freaking dangerous to be. The FBI guys carry like heavy guns. And it does indicate, if you didn't already track with it, Donald Love is into some weird shit if the FBI is on him. So I thought we had it there. I really thought we were going to be done with this mission, but getting the packages is not enough. You still got some work to do, because you got to get them to Donald Love. I thought there might be like a drop-off point that you could reach via the boat. We're fairly safe as long as we're in the boat, so our best bet is probably to see if we can get to the safe house on the first island. I don't remember if there's any place where you can just, like, beach that thing and then grab a car and race to your safe house on the first island. And that's where, I mean, if you're like, hey, that's cheating. Well, I mean, it's really the same as getting to a pay and spray, effectively. So I've got all these police wanted stars, so it'll make it really easy to lose the wanted level if I can just get to our hideout. And for some reason, the pay and sprays don't seem to be marked. I think that's not, I think one of the Kenji missions we did kind of glitches the pay and sprays, so you can't see them on the map anymore, which is annoying. They're still there, they still work, but you kind of got to know where they are. Either way, let's see if we can actually get all the way to the boat without wiping out our car this time. Been kind of a tricky mission for us.
You say with your Diablo or with your hood, don't come with no bad vibration. It will do you no good. Yeah.
Almost come back to this point and get in that car. Not that I positioned it right, but if that car is still there, that wouldn't be a terrible plan. It seems to start dropping them around here. Make sure to get the packages before anything else. And I'm already messing that up. Fuck. Fuck. Okay. It's all right. It's all right. If I could see anything, this would be easier. But I missed one of the packages. Okay. The other one was up here. They've all been dropped, and they are in kind of a row, so I'm just gonna get them all. Fuck! You son of a bitch! He just showed up. He just spawned at the last possible second. Okay. The boat maneuvering is so painful in this game. And not that it should work like a car, but they're trying to make it... They're trying to, like, use the same controls for a car and simulate the fact that a boat really wouldn't work that way by making it a car that just handles like shit. Alright. Don't want to spend a whole nother video on this mission, but... I mean, whatever it takes, we gotta get this done. It will give us our final... So a police car is rolling over and flips into me, and then I get a wanted level because I didn't avoid it when it was actually got knocked into the incoming traffic lane. I was actually in the correct traffic lane. I actually obeyed traffic laws there. We love the scientists, the only artists that we play here on Keja. Apparently there was a lawsuit between Greensleeve Records, which released this album, and the scientist, who's the name of the dub artist, because what I didn't understand, this is dubbed, like he was bringing this together from like other existing tracks of music. He didn't actually write any of this. So he was trying to sue for copyright, and basically the courts are like, you didn't write any of the music. Like, you edited it together. You didn't write any of it. So, interesting case there. I guess my feelings on it depend on whether he actually paid anything to the artists whose music he used. That would make a big difference into how much sympathy I had for the scientist in this case. And you know that the scientist is just trying to do his best, but fucking Rand Paul shows up, makes everyone call him doctor, because he's a no longer licensed ophthalmologist, and just undercuts all of the scientist's work at all times. It's pretty frustrating for the scientist, actually. He's trying to tell people about fighting the Curse of the Voodoo Vampires, and fucking Rand Paul shows up and tells people not to listen to him. It's hard for the scientist. Okay, don't mess up on this part here, but honestly, it should be focusing in on the boat bit to come. It's so fucking dark, I can't see anything. On the off chance this thing respawns, I'm thinking that might be an interesting path. Try to get back to that car, and then use it to get to a pay and spray or to our base. Because the roads are just simpler and easier to navigate on the first island. Now we've got so much time to spare that the danger is that I like misposition myself. Because the plane's not ready to go yet. So I'm trying to second guess where the plane is going to need us to be. Dropped a package and I didn't see it. Okay, it's right here. I was so freaking close to being in the right spot. And it's all going to fuck already. It's immediately going to shit here. I hate the boats in this game. Like, we're already fucked. We're already fucked. There's got to be packages. Like, I don't know if this is the next package to get or if I already missed half of them. So we must have missed one earlier. And if I can go back and find it before the cops do, we're fine. But it's going to be like flashing at random. May or may not pop up when we need it to so that I can actually see it. Cops are probably going to get it first. They're right over there. But I can't tell where it is. Oh, there it is. Okay. All right, this is our best chance. I need to get back to this little quay here. All right, so that what a quay is? I think I'm using the word quay wrong, but it's okay. Okay, now these assholes are shooting at me from a helicopter, about which I can do nothing, but my car is still here. This could work out. It's going to depend on whether cars spawn in our way before we can get even back on the main roads, or if something like that happens, which would be bad. Okay. I'm going to make a... So they're right after us. We just need to make a mad run for our base. Try to avoid any cop cars on the way. And hope I remember exactly where to turn in. And not get in a situation like that. Here we go. Fuck. Nope. Not quite coppers. Not quite coppers. You think you got me? You don't. You can all just back off. It's so tempting to steal one of their cars right now. But that would give me a wanted level. But only a 1-star. But I shouldn't have done it. I should not have done it. Okay. I should not have done that. That was not a good decision. But I've got a 1-star wanted level, which I can just wait out. I got greedy trying to get that FBI car. Although one of them is still intact. Holy crap, I can still come out of this with an FBI car. I'm coming out of this with an FBI car, guys. FBI car, guys. I can't use words anymore, guys. But I'm coming out of this with no wanted level. I'm going to have an FBI car. It's in terrible shape. So I probably need to either get it to a pay and spray for repair. I didn't want to mess with getting my bulletproof Banshee out of the garage. Honestly, if I drive into any section of town at all with baddies, I risk them shooting my car and blowing it up. So let's see if we can just get back on the bridge. FBI cars are pretty resilient, actually. It's not seems doesn't seem to be smoking anymore for RIP. Yeah, FBI cars are kind of hard to come by. It's another one. I probably won't use it because I don't want to lose it, but you can't just get these anywhere, so it's kind of cool to hang on to once you've got one. So I could try to figure out where my hideout is, but I'm going the wrong way. Again. It's up here somewhere, isn't it? Yeah, let's get this thing parked in the hideout. And then take our time and get back. Now that we got no wanted level, we can just take our time about delivering this stuff to Donald Love. But let's make sure we get this FBI car safely stowed away. Now, I really don't want to screw this up at this point. It's certainly possible. I could, like, at any point, you can, like, randomly drive off of a bridge in this game, or I'm going to jack a car to get to Donald Love. I could do that right in front of a cop, get a wanted level, and that could all go south. This particular stretch of road is pretty safe. You don't usually have cartels all the way out here. Okay. It's like a nice white van. Steal it with no cops around. Run over a guy. All according to plan here. Shine till there's no shine no more. So, the FBI really didn't want Donald Love getting his hands on this stuff. Apparently, he is somebody that the government really wants to bring down. But it's not going to happen today. We've got 10,000 buckaroos. And I thought that unlocked the island, so let's get in the car and see if we can get a radio announcement or something.
Good news.
There we go.
Good news for commuters from Shoreside. Engineers have finally managed to repair the damaged mechanism on the Staunton Lift Bridge, and it is now open to traffic flow both to and from Shoreside Vale.
So that is the bridge right there they're talking about. That for a while we could not use. Okay, so if I get game over now, I'm accepting it and just losing the ammo, that's fine. But I don't want one, so let's see if I can avoid getting one. Yeah, this is the end of town that has, like, super hot cars in it. And you kind of have to, like, there's a trick to getting the extension bridge to do what you need it to do. Let's go save in case I screw something up. But yeah, I'm going to want to wrap this video up by getting that last package if I can. That would actually be enough that I could probably just call it a session, or at least take a little break and go for a walk. Because I really want to get to the point where I've got that last hidden package. That's been preventing me from going out and actually enjoying the outdoors a little bit today. So you can do vigilante missions in the FBI car, I believe. But I couldn't get my hands on any. Like, I was trying off-screen at one point with just, like, all of these hidden packages and armor pickups to, like, create enough rampage to get, like, a 6-star wanted level on Jack or Rhino, and it seems to be locked. Like, I don't think you can get a 6-star wanted level until you reach a certain point in the story. Anyway, we now have the entire map at our disposal, although the story really doesn't do very much with that last island. And it's a huge pain in the ass to navigate, so I'm not in a big rush to go there. Some of these missions will have us doing stuff over there. And when that happens, we will go there. Otherwise, the lift bridge is the location of the final hidden package. Or at least it's the final hidden package for us, because it's the only one that you really just couldn't find a way to get to without that bridge functioning. When the bridge is broken, it's always in the up position. Puerto Rican and black. It's when the bridge is broken, it's always in the up position. That was the cop's fault. That was the cop's fault. But anyway. Okay, so this is not the right way to be either. Now I got a 2-star wanted level. This is a pain in the ass. I guess this is why I saved. Trying to fight, then I start thinking about the last time he lied. Basically, you're just a whore. That's what I'm saying. Don't know the right street to be on to get on the extension bridge. But that's going to be kind of key to actually get this to work. Alright, let's just ditch these cops because this is getting old. Agalong! It's like a little kid going, Agalong! All my sisters keep rising to the top. So it would be useful to know for future reference which block I want to be turning left on to get to the next island. Here we go. So I don't actually know. I don't remember how to get this. We just went. Oh, we went back. We didn't go forward. Am I sure about that? No, I think this is the third island. I need to, it does this thing where it lifts up and down, and you need to be... I don't know, I might have to look up how to do this, but, let me just pull up a YouTube video while we wait. How to actually do this correctly. It's GTA 3 bridge. Hidden package, yeah. Because it's somehow you get this thing to actually lift. Oh, and there's a way to do it with a dodo. I'm not looking for that. I'm gonna have to actually navigate around a guide and find this thing. Because the bridge will lift sometimes. You gotta be on it when it lifts. But I don't know how to get it to do that. I think I'm on the right. No, this is the Callahan Bridge. It's the wrong bridge. Okay, no wonder it's not working. Callahan Bridge is the first bridge. The suspension bridge is a different bridge. So let's go find the actual bridge that we need. That might help. This video might go a little long, but I feel like once I actually... Okay. Okay, so we want to be crossing this bridge. The Pimpers Pimp. Hustlers hustle. Oh, y'all. So I need to get to the other side of this park. Go up here and then. Presumably, this gets us there. It's not getting us there either. I don't... Well, I mean, I can hear the lift bridge operating, but I don't know how we get... How does this damn thing work. You come over here and you... I don't understand how to get on this bridge. I'm pretty sure the first time I went to the third island, I used the tunnel, not the bridge. Don't know the correct pathing here. Let's see. If you're coming down this way. There's obviously an on-ramp I'm going to have to find. Here we go. This might be it. No, I'm going underneath it again. I was in a situation somewhat similar to this in real life once, and yeah, it's pretty damn frustrating. Okay, I think if we can get up here and get on... We're in an underpass, but I can get on the overpass. That's probably what we need to do.
All the way live from the bridge, nature, big stretch. This is what we do, kid. Yo,
well, I don't know. How are we going to get to it from here? There's got to be an on-ramp. It might really be easier just to... Hold on. You are now... Okay, I kept turning off early because I thought this was going to go straight. Actually should have been on this... Yeah, I should have... This should have... That made this a lot harder than it really is. Okay. Somehow you gotta figure out where the right spot is and wait for it to go up and climb on it. Yeah, this is the third island. Get to the Paypone in Wichita Gardens. And we'll talk. That would be, I believe, D-Ice of the Red Jacks, who has a series of phone missions for us. There we go. I gotta get up on that thing, so let's not roll the car. That's not gonna help. What I need to do is get... So now, I'm on the section that goes up and down. And what's going on here is there's a hidden package floating up there. So I have to be able to get up to it. And the lift bridge is the intended way. But if you play around with the dodo, which I haven't showcased yet, you can kind of get it without doing the lift bridge, but... It seems like a huge pain in the ass to me. So this should allow us to get it. Oh, here we are. There it is. Rocket launcher delivered to hideout. Easy peasy. Might as well get our new hideout established, I guess. This video is going long, obviously, but we'll get to a new base and save there, and then ultimately have to drive all the way back to the second island anyway, unless I decide to do de-ice missions next. But at this point, I can do the missions in whatever order I want. There's no longer anything where I will block missions permanently by mistake. The only other thing motivating my order of missions was wanting to get this island unlocked and get the third or the final hidden package. So now I can just kind of do whatever. And try not to fall in water while running around looking for Wichita Gardens. Which I think is actually quite easy to do around here if I'm not careful. So let me get back away from the edge of the roads. But yeah, this is a really confusing section of town. I learned it a bit while trying to do all the firefighter missions and whatnot. But it's by... these are the Red Jacks. Okay, this is a hoodie rumpo. I kind of forgot. The hoods in this... The gangs in this section of town drive rumpos. So I just figured this was just a regular old truck. But no, it's a gang truck. And I have agitated baddies by stealing it. It also handles really weird. Anyway, this video is going super long, but when it is done, we will have completed. We'll have a new island at our disposal, and we'll have a new Wappets or Wappet. So it seems like a good deal overall. And it's such a pain in the ass to get to our safe house. Driving across the top of a dam. I don't think this is the most efficient way to get there anyway. Oh, no, it is. And there's going to be a whole bunch of Colombians hanging around in this area, too. But we've got all these roads that are, like, zigzaggy roads that are meant to, like, take care of big amounts of, like, vertical distance. And the vigilante missions in this part of town are a nightmare because people spawn really far away from you in places that are extremely difficult and painful to get to. But eventually, and this is also, this island is like the hood. Like, the first island had the old industrial district and the Italians and the Chinese. Then we went to the fancy, like, island that had, I forgot I had cars saved here from when I was doing vigilante missions. But the first one's kind of the old school island, and it's got the Italians and the Chinatown. And then you've got the business center, which I guess would be Manhattan. This, I don't know if it's Brooklyn or the Bronx, but this is like, yeah, this is where the, I mean, they're called the Hoods Rumpo. This is where the African-American street gangs hang out, and this is where the projects are. And it's kind of like, oh, you think that the fanciest, nicest part of town would be unlocked last? Not really. But now, we're actually getting 20 rounds of rocket launcher ammo every time we save. And all is right in the world as we come to our beautiful hood home base. And we haven't gone long enough for me to try to extend this into two and split it after the fact, so I'll just call it a video. When we come back next time, the world is our oyster. There's only one mission other than the de-ice missions that spawns on the third island, so I'll probably be heading back to the second island, but... Now that we've unlocked the third island, I can kind of do the missions in whatever order feels right. So I'm guessing I'll go do something for Ray to finish up his plotline and then go back to Donald Love until Asuka appears again. I don't know. Asuka eventually will reappear because she doesn't know it. At least we hope she doesn't. But we killed her brother. So you'd think there'd be some resolution to that storyline. We'll see in future videos. Bye-bye, guys.